Good morning, everybody. Welcome to another Daily Mark Report brought to you by Mike Bjork. Today is Tuesday and it's June 12th. We got quite the day today here, so let's kind of jump right into it. We'll start off with the economic calendar. Today we got the NFIB Small Business Index. This is an index that kind of provides the confidence level of small businesses, which is important primarily because make the bulk of unemployment numbers in our job data. So we've been seeing some very high numbers here. We've had back in April 104.8, and it jumped 3 points to 107.8. Out of a 45-year history, this is the second highest rating ever for NFI Small Business Confidence. And basically, again, it reiterates they're confident in where the economy is moving. They base their credit in it towards the tax cuts as well as regulatory changes that's making it a little bit more business friendly and trying to help them. And actually, the biggest problem right now, which is a nice problem to have, is finding qualified workers to work. That's the biggest problem right now. So, a good problem, obviously, to have. We'd rather have that problem than not having enough jobs and more people on unemployment. Now, we also got the inflation data here for Consumer Price Index, or also known as the CPI, for the month of May. So in April, it was up 0.2%. The forecast was supposed to be 0.2, so it came in at forecast at 0.2%. So this jumped from 2.5% to 2.8% year over year. And then we got, when you strip out the food and energy, this is kind of more the number that we look at primarily because of the, even though the other one is more of the headline number you'll see in newspapers, the core is what they look at because it strips out the volatility of the food and energy prices that could be the various that could vary all the time, and there's no control over those pricing because we can't control weather on in terms for food, for example, if there's a drought or something like that and food aren't being produced, so obviously the price will go up. We can't control that, so. That's why they strip that out of the core, out of the CPI and create the core. Same thing with PCE and the other inflation data here. So in April, we had a 0.1% increase for the core. Forecast was supposed to be 0.2% for May, and it came right at forecast. So economists were spot on in their forecast. And this one goes from 2.1 to only 2.2. So not as big of an increase as the headline number on there, so year over year, so 2.1 to 2.2 year over year on there. So this isn't the Fed's favorite gauge. Their favorite gauge is the PCE or personal consumption expenditure, but it does have its importance, and the Fed does look at it. But again, they weigh PCE a little bit has a little bit carries a little bit more weight in terms of their decision making for inflation data. Now let's jump ahead over to the headline news. Stock market is up. Dow is down a little bit here so far this morning, but now since we've started creating this, it's gone up. It's basically on the heels of the North Korea meeting. It turned out to be so far successful. Very optimistic about it. I think a lot of people should be pretty proud as this is historic, where this is the first time a North Korean leader as well as U.S. president actually met since they've broken up. And and basically they signed an agreement today and ending gradually eliminating or making it a denuclearized area, the Korean Peninsula. So obviously we have to be cautiously optimistic. We hope that this continues, but on the other hand, things can happen from time they sign it, in the future. But I think everybody wants to be cautiously optimistic and not have to have be worried about somebody with nuclear weapons and threatening you. So this is obviously a good sign for all to into the future here. Also today we got the FOMC meeting beginning, their 2-day meeting. So they start their meeting today, and then tomorrow they give their announcement. Now tomorrow we do expect them to provide a quarter rate hike. So that would be the first or the second of this year, and then they are expecting a third probably in the September one. And then if they continue, if the economy is still heating up, they may put a fourth one. That's the one that's at 50-50 chance, and most likely in December if that happens. So again, rates are continuing to grow up, and the September one could be important primarily because right now we have the yield spread difference between a 10-year and 2-year treasury is about 0.42%. Now it's going to drop about another quarter point after tomorrow's rate hike. Now, by September, we're going to be probably at an inverted curve, which traditionally or historically meaning that kind of leads us into recession. This had me kind of thinking. Maybe you guys could put your thoughts down below. Had me thinking in regards to recession. If we go into a technical recession, is it going to be pretty short-lived? Right now we have more job openings than we have people in the labor force are participating. And even if we eliminate some jobs, and with the current tax cuts and with the regulations, a lot of these employers are willing to hold on to employees until we weather that storm and not lay off people. So to me, that poses a question out there that maybe this so-called recession that we may go into may not be all that bad anyways. So, and this is the longest in history that we've gone between periods between a recession. We've never historically never gone 10 years without a recession. We've just basically kind of passed that a little bit. So let's kind of move on here. I don't want to keep you guys too long, but here's the bond market today. We're down about 5 basis points, but this we had a what they call a bond rollover, which is a basically what I explained yesterday was a kind of a reset in the pricing for bonds. So because each month they package up the bonds and they sell them to investors on Wall Street, and that's what kind of drives interest rates here. And then they do a reset. There's no effect to our rate sheet in terms of pricing. Even though it looks like it's lower, it doesn't mean it's gone down. Your pricing is worse. And so right now, pricing is about the same as where we left off yesterday, which is obviously good news. But it does take us a little bit further away from this 25-day moving average. However, on this 10-year treasury, we're still testing this 25-day moving average, but so far it's been keeping it tight. So this is giving us some, again, I would say cautious optimistic, kind of like the North Korea treaty, right? Be very cautiously optimistic. So far it's holding, but for how long? And will give us a chance, it's giving us a chance to keep the rates where they're currently at. If it does break above that, look for, as you see, we got a pretty big spread here until the next ceiling, and that could lead to a pretty good run on interest rates. So interest rates will jump up. Now, coming up in July, we have another the Fed. They're going to be cutting more on their asset purchases, so that will probably tend to be a lot less demand for bonds, and therefore probably raise excuse me, interest rates will probably rise again in July. So be cautious out there that you don't run into July and you get caught in trouble here for regards to if you're floating interest rates on refinance or purchasing. July could be a month where rates could climb again due to the Fed's again they're reducing each quarter, and that's the new quarter, reducing their purchases on the mortgage-backed securities and treasuries here. All right, so rates are about the same as what we left off yesterday. So that pretty much wraps things up. If you guys want to get more data, just come over on Twitter. You'll find more as I set more stuff out there throughout the day. I'm Mike Bjork at Twitter. Hope to see you guys there. Hopefully you guys follow me, and we'll look forward to see you guys tomorrow. Thanks again for watching. Have a good day. Bye-bye.